Hello, my warriors! How is it going? Welcome to another episode of BattleTech RogueTech Flashpoint 0998, and we are playing a bunch of new missions today, guys. The catapult has to be refit because we have a nice LRM 50 launcher that I want to put into that thing, and then we're gonna see if we can get some, squeeze some more performance out of there, shall we, guys? Yes, we shall. Now, we have an engine here that gives us a minus 15% engine weight factor change, also 10% weapon heat generated. That engine is not really good, but it's also not terrible. I'm thinking that I want that Clan XL engine. You see where I'm going? This is a 1.4 million investment. I don't think that we have enough money for that, though. Damn it. 1.4? Maybe we can get there. Maybe. See, the thing is that we just need, and when I say just need 1 million. And we have a bunch of stuff here that I'm not necessarily taking anymore. So maybe we will get there, guys, and I want to have that thing just refit so that we can then squeeze in another LRM-15 launcher. You see where I'm going with this? I guess so. So we dropped the rockets. We don't need them anymore. We also don't necessarily need the prototype heat sinks here. I have a feeling that we are all set for this. That's actually looking like a decent build here. Yeah, heat sinking is 40, but the Alpha Strike is 62. That is really good. Alright, guys, this is how we roll here. 7 days, 1.4 million C-bills. I wonder, however, if we have enough ammunition left. So we have 400 shots with our Hydra LRM. Sorry for that. And we shoot, what is that, 32? That's 32 times 2. That's 60... 64. So, that's not good. That's not enough. That's the problem. I could also just drop one of those pirate LRMs. Maybe that's the way to go about this here. I mean, that would save us 6 more tons. Would also drop a little bit of our damage potential. I mean, at the same time, I get to keep my proto heat sinks, right? I get to keep the rockets, which are nice to have, I guess. And then we can add some medium lasers, maybe. Maybe heavy medium lasers. Now, we go with extended range smalls? Oh, we got a light PPC, I just realized. We can take that. That gives us something interesting here. This weapon has a recoil of 0. Okay, thanks for letting me know. But it ignores one evasion and it has the PPC scrambling effect. I really like that. I really like that idea. Also, we can bring the Rocket 10 back. And now we have 65 tons. This seems like a decent build, honestly. I really want to play it like that. I'm changing the Pirate LRM, obviously, because it has minus 1 accuracy, and this LRM-15 has plus 1 accuracy, and it's just better to hit stuff instead of having just 2 more missiles that we can shoot and saving up 1 ton. You know what? I want to do it like that. It's 12 days refit, and now we need to get the money! So, how do we do it? We go to the store, and we are going to sell some stuff. Hello, store! So, what are we going to sell here? I will go ahead and sell the Pirate Gauss Rifle. I don't think that we will ever use that. The Large Pulse Laser. It's just good money. I'm just going for the big numbers here. I see a Light Rifle. Okay. Too hot. Too hot for the moment. We will find more later. Okay, what else? Machine Gun Array Pirate. Well, I like that idea. I'm gonna keep them. For later, guys, for later. We don't need a single Narc Beacon, we have one already. That small laser needs to find way into the OZL, by the way. The Snub-Nose PPC can go as well. Bye. There are 2 Thunderbolt missiles that we can sell. And I think we are getting there. And then, of course, we have the Pirate Engine that we don't need anymore. Goodbye. There's a Fusion Core. Goodbye. And as you can see, we are, just by selling some stuff, already almost there again. We don't even have to scrap our max for that. Accuracy or heat? The heat is actually not that interesting, honestly. I'm gonna keep that. I don't know. Maybe there will be a time where we need that thing. We have 2 double heatsink upgrade kits. And we don't need them. We can get rid of one. that would have already set us up for a good, for a good amount of money. Okay, so next thing is gonna be the Uziel, because that thing needs to get the better small laser, and then we're gonna drop on the battlefield. Two larges, one small plus, one small pulse, X-pulse, machine gun array, could put this in here. Doesn't make a big difference because we only have an upper arm actuator. Only the lower arm actuator gives you a 2-hit bonus, so we don't have that. We were having that thing destroyed at some point, and now it's gone. But it's okay. Anything else I want to do before we start playing the first rounds? I don't think so. I mean, I want to do something. I'm not entirely sure if I can. I mean, training modules. It's just super cheap, it's super good early on, and I will buy it just right now. Because it needs to be done. I want the passive XP gain for my rookies. So here we go. Training module 1 coming up. Ulysses is still out of action, but I will give him one more day after the catapult is ready to recover. And then we drop. And we're gonna take a look at our mech warriors before we do that. Hello, Ariamaki. I want you to get high gunnery, so let's go for that. Starbird has that already. Yep, Ulysses, same thing here, I guess. Yeah, I want to have him go to gunnery 6, and then we go down the tactics path, because he's our scout at the moment. There we go. That's what I like to see. So, with the minus 1 recoil penalty, we can easily shoot our AC-10 now. And Von Cobra really needs to play the Enforcer all the time, for that reason. Okay, guys. First contract of the day. Let's go ahead and play a 2-skull battle. Ooh, assassination could be interesting. Fly lines, another battle. Destroy base. Yeah, we have some really nice missions here. I want to play this this early battle here. Oh, it's a greater Valkyrid. It's a riposte. Nope. We were playing supply lines here. I'm too afraid of going up against super strong mechs at the moment. Again, Von Cobra needs to be on the Enforcer, thanks to the recoil penalty reduction that we have now. And I want to bring back Ulysses. Coach got some nice experience, his first run on the battlefield. But Ulysses is gonna be my main pilot, and for that reason I'm gonna put him into the Raven. So let's do it. If you ever want to progress, you may need a punch above your lance's weight. Choose your contracts carefully and you can get yourself some great salvage. And that's what we try to do today. I am actually thinking that we will go for the assassination mission after this here, because I like good salvage, you know me, right? Okay. The Clan XL engine definitely makes sense on our catapult, because it is a mech that we will field a long, long time. And getting basically the best equipment into that thing is, you know, keeping us all set up for the long run. Therefore, I will definitely do that. So, battle. Are we going up against... Lurens! Ooh, hello Steiner guys. Let's see if we can salvage some nice Atlas parts. No, I actually don't want to face an Atlas. I do not.
Command interface initiated.
Cool, let's go.
And I forgot my
beat. Ah, it's this mission. I don't like that. This is difficult. Alright. Let's position ourselves. I could do something else. I could try to take the high ground. Can I get up here? Probably not. No, we have to really push down there all the time. There's just no way around it. Unless you had jump jets, then you can get up there and then shoot from the high ground. But so be it.
Got it.
Morning doesn't help. That's a lesson I taught my son, or I'm still trying to teach my son. He is sometimes in a state where he would be so frustrated and he doesn't know what to do anymore, and then he would either cry or he would just throw things around, and I'm like, hey, that doesn't help with your situation. You could ask me if you're not getting the stuff done, or you could try in a different approach. But mourning doesn't help. Mourning, not mourning. Mourning. Moaning? I have no idea how to pronounce that. I did get the point, right? So,
Commander.
Again, that is a lesson that I try to... Back. Ooh, Hunchback. That's nice. It's a gridiron, by the way. That's a Gauss Hunchback. Ooh, scary.
Hold
Again, that's a lesson that I'm trying to teach him.
Picked up a blip.
There's another Valiant. Valiants wear those melee mechs. And the Hatchet Man! Help, please. Can I not get hit by your hatchet, please? I don't know how to engage this. They have a great long-range mech and then two short-range melee mechs. This guy will be shielded from those two unless I have them destroyed. Bad.
Ready for orders.
All of them have done stuff, right?
Got it.
Holding for tactical advantage.
Okay, let's see what we can do. Again, moaning doesn't help.
On the move.
Hello! I'm here! I'm a raven! What are you? I actually have the feeling that I want to destroy the gridiron as quickly as possible. And as you can see, they have only 50% of their armor, so we go with the big target first. He's also twisted in, so that means that if we grind through the side torso, we destroy his Gauss rifle on the right hunch. There it is. Isn't it beautiful? Hello, Hunchback. Hello. Yeah, okay, so for that reason... I think I gotta keep pushing now. 22, 17, sprinting, 17, 12, 8. Okay.
Affirmative.
For the sake of having a little bit of a higher hit chance, we do that. It's raining.
How's it going?
I'm pretty happy that I chose the Hunchback as my first target, though. What hatchet man is that? Oh, God.
Engaging.
I really do hope that they don't get reinforcements. So the arm is slowly getting destroyed. We destroyed the hand actuator there. It's not enough though.
Roger.
Okay, how much hesitation do we get? It's okay.
Yep.
I don't want to get hit by the Valiant.
Confirmed.
Mm-hmm. So far, so good. I think we destroyed a laser or something. Ah, there's also a guy. A Valkyrie. I'm out of here.
Confirmed.
Goodbye. I don't want to live on this planet anymore.
Receiving you.
Doing the same thing here. Not this.
Firing.
And we pull back. Let's try to play it somewhat smart. So, Ace Pilot is such a wonderful thing to have. Yep. The Valkyrie. So, we have to deal with three melee mechs. The Valkyrie being the most sturdy one. I think this thing is running a combat shield? A built-in combat shield? A regular combat shield? I cannot remember. The Valiant has a combat shield as well. Small combat shield, I believe. And then there's the Hatchet Man. Trying to get the high ground here. Smart. Please don't have reinforcements. That's the gridiron.
Yes, Commander.
Alright, we can get line of sight, but only to the Valkyrie. I think we kind of are blocked here. We cannot really go anywhere.
Copy that.
So, what's our hit chance? It's not too bad. We have 33% there. Yep. I will go with the hit chance here. And I will not fire my rockets because I want to keep them for later.
Engaging.
So, damage. Damage has been dealt. Guess we're gonna switch targets now because it's the only one that we have. Or I push in here. Hello, Hunchback.
Fire.
That was a miss. It was to be expected. I want to crit his Gauss. Come on. These mechs are so scary. Oh no, Valkyria. Ah, wait. What? 30 ton mech? I thought it was a 55 ton. What am I missing here? Oh, it's a Valkyrie. It's a Valiant. Valkyrie? What was that other thing? It was Valkyria. But this is a Valkyrie. I believe I'm right in that regard. I have no idea. No hit chance here whatsoever. That's bad. We wait. Let the other guys do something first. Here comes the Grid Iron. He's running a medium pulse. He's not shooting though! Okay, now that's good. That's really good. Means that we can shoot him from here and see if we can destroy, again, his side torso. It's so damn important. In this case, I will shoot my rockets as well. I think we have him. Yep.
Smoked one.
Yep, yep, yep. I think that was the Gauss explosion and then everything went boom. Very good. So, Gridiron is down. But now, the little one punching my catapult. I wonder how much damage potential he actually has. Ooh, 88! Okay. Okay!
Armor breach. Internal
orders.
Wow! I mean, I was expecting damage, but 88 from a light mech is ridiculous. Not the flamers. Or only one flamer here. It's important to somehow tag him. Okay. Seems to be a regular hatchet man. Yeah, AC-10 and two mediums. Man, if I can get my hands on this hatchet man, I would be so happy. Seriously. That would be amazing. 50%. Or 40. Yeah. So this guy needs to get out of my way. Definitely.
Definitely.
Yeah. In order to get that done, I think I will... Oof. Those machine gun arrays are hot. I'm trying to go for the crits here.
Locked on gear arm.
Okay, I didn't get it done.
What's up, boss?
Cobra. Mm-hmm. 46.
Acknowledge.
Ah, can we at least destroy something of this guy? I think I also use Vigilance here, by the way. Was the leg. I mean, if we have initiative with the Raven, it would be fine. He's running away. Okay. Okay. That helps. That definitely helps. Alrighty. 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 Yeah, I think I will hunt him down with Arya Maki, actually. Because Maki is faster. Mm-hmm. So he can reposition later on. Even if we are getting out of position right now. I think I will still go with the machine guns here. Let's do it.
Target locked in.
The thing is, we don't need much in terms of getting some crits on the guy, getting head hits even. And if we could have destroyed the leg with just multiple hits on the leg, it would have been great. For that reason, I also reserved the Starbird. I want Ulysses first. Then there's the Valkyrie. Yeah, he's running some LRMs, I believe. An LRM 10 maybe, and then a medium laser. It's not that big of a deal, it's not that big of a threat.
Receiving you.
However, over time, it's nasty. So, backstabbing.
Just running. Got it.
This is not so much about the damage, but to prime him for getting killed. Let's go.
Gotcha. Hey, what's the flank?
Yeah, I know. The hatchet man has jump jets. I need to remember that. As soon as he's down there, we need to instantly converge over. Okay.
On the move.
If that's the way we do it, then that's the way we do it. We don't shoot the AC here, as well as the ER medium laser.
Firing at enemy six.
Come on! Not enough! AP Gauss, definitely. Not the Hydra. Let's go. That's the leg. Okay, cool. Also, that's the mech. Yeah. And he panicked out. Pretty good. Oh, I like that. I like that. Hmm. In this phase here, I will wait for the hatchet man to do a move.
For tactical advantage.
I wonder what he's gonna do. Yes, he can shoot my enforcer in the back, but not really much that he can do. I hope. Yeah, he's going for my catapult anyway. Pretty good. The question is, do we go for the hatchet man now?
Yes, boss. Waiting for the right move.
Give me my spotter. Give me my scout. Yeah, I have to sprint. But that's okay. So our Narc is at 37% hit chance. Alright, we only dealt damage and we dealt it to the front, to the center there. I don't like that. No, I want to preserve that mech somehow. Can I? Please? Can I have a hatchet man? Game, please? This will accelerate my gameplay so, so much. This hatchet man alone can carry me through the whole mid game.
Yes, Commander. Copy that.
I don't want to shoot my AC. It's too much damage. I want to soften him up and then try to go with the crits. Okay, that works.
Critical hit, Commander.
It's also unsettled. So, what do we do here? No PPC. AP Gauss, yes or no? No. The LRMs have a crit chance, guys. Increased 25% crit chance. We got one crit on the engine.
Critical hit.
And I think he's pretty damn damaged. Yeah, he is. Man, if we could get a knockdown, that would have been amazing. But maybe we can.
Receiving you.
Only the machine guns.
Taking the shot.
Okay, he failed stability check and he panicked. That is good. That is really good. And now you go like over here.
On the move.
Okay.
Aye, aye.
Ulysses. You know what I'm gonna do now? I'm gonna shoot only the tag and the Narc to the head. Oh, they deal zero damage now. Is it because of the forest that he's lying in? Might be.
Firing on target.
They actually dealt one damage. But it didn't make him panic more. Damn, that's what I was hoping for.
Move into position.
I need very tiny instances of damage here. So, Starbird. Starbird doing nothing yet. I want to have Ariamaki. Oh wait, we are still on his turn. And he is still about to act. Damn. I don't want to destroy the center. I will go for the headshot, but only with one LRM. Yeah, he's done. Oh, sad face.
Enemy.
Sad face.
On my way.
I think we will take it anyway. Or we start taking this anyway.
Acknowledged.
Shoot everything. And then we go home.
With all weapons. Yes, boss?
Ulysses, yes, obviously first, because he has the Narc, the tag, and everything. Oh, he doesn't get a line of sight. Oh, wait, where? Yeah. This is as good as it gets right now. Overheat alert. Yeah.
I'm on it.
One missile hit.
How's it going?
Maki. Ooh, flanking. And I think this is the time where we just go all in. I don't care about heat here. I was hoping that we could destroy or at least leg him.
Something good.
Override successful. Yet again, guys, the first overheat cannot trigger ammo explosion. Though I was pretty safe doing that. And even if I was shutting down, the worst thing that could have happened was a guy shooting an LRM-10 and a medium laser at me. I don't care. Kill! That'll get a job done. Guys, as soon as we have access to clan LRM-15s, that's where the build becomes really, really good. Because then we can stack like 4, maybe 5 of them, maybe even 6 with the right build. And then just go crazy on that. The Hydra LRM ammo is pretty decent. I really like that. It just is +1 to everything. +1 heat, +1 damage, +1 stability damage. That thing is so damn versatile. And I like it. The problem that we would have there if we stack 4-5 launchers is that we would run out of ammo. So we either go for something that is energy based as a support weapon, or we put regular ammo in there. So definitely the hatchet man. That's a no-brainer. We will take that. We had one Valiant part, right? There are three more on the ground. Oh, there's a fire control system for Gauss. Plus 3 accuracy. Really? You really want to make that thing hit, huh? Okay, I see what you did there. Oh, a mask. Hmm. Thank you. I'll take it. That's for later, guys. That's for later. Hmm, 2 Valiant parts. That's also not too bad. And a medium pulse. Hmm, pretty good. I think the medium pulse will find way into the Uziel, because again, I want to make it a close range mech. Oh, I didn't check if I had double heat sinks out of this, if I got double heat sinks out of that, because we need that for the Uziel. It is supposed to be my short range backstabber, my short range burst mech that can easily flank the enemy, go into the side, which not only gives us a higher hit chance, but also gives us the ability to just grind through a single side torso. Because the other side is completely shielded from that damage, so it can only hit arm, side, center, and leg on that side, and then grind through it and then blow up the side torso for XL destruction. That's what I really, really like, especially early on when it's super safe to just kill quickly. Aha! We have a Valiant! Okay. Let's see what we have there. Now that is a knife. That is our first melee mech, guys. It's coming with the Vibra Sword attached. That's really good. 50 melee damage! Ooh. And 30%! Okay. And the combat shield is repairable. Okay, so what did we lose here? The heatsink kit. Yeah, that's unfortunate. Patchwork material. This is basically in a pretty good shape still. Okay. It is a small mech. It is a light mech. But it is exactly what we need. Yeah, guys, we have a melee mech. It's not going to be super good. It is something for the early game. But it will do. It will just do. No, I'm pretty unhappy that I put my pirate engine to the torch. I'll take Endo, and then we should have no, yeah, slot problems and weight problems anymore. We have a single ER medium. A single ER medium. I mean, that thing is supposed to run around like crazy, anyway. Mask is 3 tons. No, 1.5. Okay, never mind. That will actually get us more movement. We take the mask. Now we need 0.5 ton, but I think we had patchwork materials. No, we don't. Fuck. I want to play this, guys. It is just a Vibro Sword. 4 melee accuracy. It's really good. So we cannot afford the mask. We're gonna keep the supercharger for the moment then. It is a dedicated melee mech. Do I want that? It's 176,000. That I'm gonna invest now. I need to think about that. I think my lance operates quite nicely. But this is a Vibro Sword. It's very squishy. It has no ECM. Yet. It's super risky running this. Because it might be just destroyed. At the same time, what would we lose? Nothing. We don't... Huh? Oh, that's interesting. What am I missing here? Oh, I'm missing the double heatsink upgrade kit. Oh yeah, we need heatsinks. Okay. Ooh, can we even field this? No, we need another double heatsink for that to work. Not good. Not good. In that case, you know what? We will not repair it. Not yet, guys. Not yet. We might do that later, but I will salvage this double heatsink for later. And I'm gonna use that for my UZL. Oh, I can't do it, right? Can't just take it out. Repair. Yeah, okay. Okay, we made a decision, guys. We're gonna play this later. Yep, confirm that. It's not ready yet, but it's gonna be. And then it's gonna be fun. So, 10 days for the next financial report. 7 days for the catapult to be ready. Mm-hmm. 3 days now. Oh, wait, actually we can start building the UZL as well. There we go. So what I want is, I think I want to take out one of those large lasers and put a medium pulse in there. Now that we have one, I'd definitely take that. There's a pulse laser. Ha! Heat management needs to get better for that reason. Ooh, 3 doubles! We can only afford 2. Wait a second. Now we are fine! Hell yeah! That's looking way better. Now we can actually shoot all of the stuff that we have there. SRM and the high explosive ammo and X-Pulse, and that's good. Yeah, we have one laser to poke early. The rest is just that. Yeah, looking good. The rest is armor. Just armor. Armoring up in the back especially, because, again, as a backstabber, I might be flanked myself at some point. Let's get that done. Actually, let's switch to tasks. No, it doesn't make a difference here. Damn. Financial report! Why now? Why? Okay, we have to. We have to sell stuff. There we go. Let's go and sell stuff. I want to sell this laser. I don't need that. I want to sell this LB2. I don't need that. I want to sell the light rifle, the LRM-10s that are lying around. I'm not entirely sure about the pirate LRMs. Yeah, they are too inaccurate. Let's go. Let's get rid of them. It's like 300,000 more that I need. Those will maybe come back. They might come back. Small lasers, no, fine. SRM-2. It's just not much that we get out of this, so I'm usually skipping this. Missile system, nope. We just get rid of the next double heatsink upgrade kit. We don't do that. Speaking of, with the amount of double heatsinks that we have left over, I could have easily built that little Valkyrie there. Valiant thing. Patchwork is super valuable. I'm gonna keep that. The PPC capacitor is probably not gonna see light of day. And that's it! I wanna keep the rest. Gonna keep that for later. Maybe we're gonna go for an SRM build later. Plasma. I like the plasma cannon. I really do. You can see the struggle, right? Okay, at this point, I will start scrapping mechs. I want to keep the rest. It's important. So, light mechs. Commando. Ravens. We don't use locusts. Ever. Javelins. Flea. Same thing. Too inexpensive. Urban Mech 2C. Panther Wolfhound Javelin. And let's get rid of the javelins as well. Scrap. And scrap. And now we're fine. Okay. We can keep playing. We can keep building. Yang is gonna handle the situation. Oh, minus 2 tech points. Damn. Yeah, I'm pretty happy that we have enough money now. Good, 26,000. It's that. And now that the UZL is ready, we're gonna drop on the battlefield once more. Taking a look at the barracks before we do. And then we go in. Yes, finally. Nice, higher gunnery is always good. You don't do anything. You are getting the next tactics. Minus 45 meter minimum range, pretty good. Ulysses, also recall penalty and the higher gunnery skill in general. And then Von Cobra going for the tactics. Alright, guys. Let's do it. Let's play an assassination mission. Where is that? Two Skull, assassination. Wait, who are we up against? The planetary government, so it seems. Cool. Maximum salvage. The assassination missions grant you a very nice target. A very special mech. A mech that usually has something super interesting in there. Or is higher in terms of category, higher in terms of tonnage that you would normally go up against in the Skull level that you are in right now. So I will definitely go for the higher Skull rating here. For the higher loot. Because I want that. I want to get some good stuff out of there. We have one part of the Hatchetman already. I mean, this is obviously the way better mech in terms of melee capacity than the... Not the Valkyrie, it's the Valiant. Because it's a medium mech. It just can take more damage, it can take more weight. It has more room for support systems. And that's why I want the Hatchetman more than the... Not Valkyrie, the Valiant. God, gotta internalize that. Two Skull. Let's see what we are up against. With the two LRM-15s, by the way, I'm super happy already. It's way better than those pirate thingies. So, reinforcements, forces, and the insurgent leader. Oh my god, we are playing this. Oh. This is a very, very difficult mission here. For the main reason that... There is one way up in the center to our special guest, and then we have enemies here and enemies here. So if we take the center path, we would be completely surrounded, except for the back. Instead, I cannot go down there. Ah, damn, I thought I could go up here. No, I can't. Okay.
If I were planning an ambush, this is where I'd put it.
I don't know if we can get out of this alive here, or without taking so much damage. Again, just the dynamics of this map, they direct us in a very weird, weird spot.
Copy that.
I just hope that I can spot enemies quickly, and then we... Sends us offline. Ah, okay. And then we go from there.
Waiting for orders. Receiving you.
Yep. Who's yelled to the front? Now we have a medium pulse. I'm super happy about that. The medium pulse is actually a very nice weapon system, especially early on. When you are facing a lot of light mechs, when you are facing a lot of mechs in shoddy or makeshift condition, then those 315 damage instances are great.
Roger that.
Nothing on the sensors so far. I wonder if they are using some kind of ECM.
Got a sensor trace.
There's one guy, a fire starter. I'll leave him there. I think I'll... At this point here, I will push to the left and try to engage those reinforcements early. And then we deal with the guys on top and on the right side.
Commander. Double time.
Ah, there they are. Commando, Locust. Commando, Locust. Okay, that's good. And an urban mech. Oh, five? You bring five enemies in the lands? That's cheating. Can tag the urban mech for a good hit chance. Can also hit the commando for a good hit chance. I will go with the commando. Ba-ba-bam! I think we have him tagged.
Yes, commander.
Uziel needs to go first because he's blocking. Fire starter. Okay.
Yes, boss.
Maki, give him hell, please. That's decent. That's a decent hit chance. And we are heat neutral, so I might fire everything. Ooh, I heard an explosion. That's good.
Think I hit something good.
I think he fell. This took far too long to... this pause here. Took far too long to not be knocked down, I believe.
Good to go.
Oh, wow. Oh, we can hit this guy already. It's a Raven. But it's a secondary objective, so it's either backstabbers or reinforcements. The enemy forces or the reinforcements. So one of those. You can actually see that by hovering over this thing. You can see right above me, there's one thing flashing, which is the enemy forces. This little cross there. I don't know if you can see it. It's very subtle. Ooh, 80, 90%? 1 out of 5? Yeah, let's go.
Locked on.
Okay.
Commander?
Starboard! Yeah, I want the catapult on the front, because it has the most armor, and it is also running an AMS, if I remember correctly. Nope. But it's running some kind of ECM, right? Yep. Okay. Yo, obviously he's not on the ground, because otherwise I would have way higher hit chance. I think this is how it works. What about the Raven, though? We will save the rockets for later. As well as the PPC. This guy has some kind of support system there. I don't know what it is. It might be a narc. It might be a tag, something.
Commander.
Cool thing is that Maki can follow up on what he he's done before. So we go into the mineral field for our own defense. And then we do this. We destroyed an arm, so there was a destruction, but it was just the arm. Pulse laser sadly did not connect. Okay. I was actually hoping for more. Little backstabber. Yeah, good thing is that we are extremely evasive right now, and we are in the mineral field. And we are in the back of the locust now, which means that we can do backstabs ourselves. Can't touch this! Ah, oh, perfect. This mineral field helps a lot.
What do you need? Copy that.
He's running a standard engine, I believe. This is just too good not to take.
All weapon systems.
Okay. So I was not shooting the commando because I don't believe that the destruction of a Psytorsa would have resulted in a kill.
Commander?
Obra. Obra, follow up. Are you okay down there? Can you manage that? Do you need the help? I'm seriously considering pushing the Raven a bit more. Or maybe even shooting from here. I'm gonna do nothing yet. We will see. Maybe there's another opportunity showing up that gives us a way higher hit chance. And again, guys, keep in mind, we have an AC-10 here. That thing destroys light mechs. This is what I'm looking for. An opportunity to get things done with that. Urban mech is in a good hit chance, yeah? If I only moved, I would... Yeah, I have to shoot indirectly. Okay.
Copy that.
So I try to just maximize the damage and try to just not really kill but destroy weapon systems. Let's go, Alpha. Okay.
My flamer is empty.
Yeah. Those were the rockets. This seems to be an, I don't know, AC-2 Locust? Is that a thing? An AC-2 on a Locust? Those are long-range missiles from the Raven. Interesting. Commander was running, and the main target is still up there. Yeah, we have to be kind of quick about that. Haha, LBX. And rockets. Oh, pepper box rifle and rockets. Good.
Ready to get it on.
And in that case... Yeah, okay.
Acknowledged.
Okay, okay, okay. So, we could shoot this guy, the Urban Mech, or the Locust, or the Firestarter. All of the hit chances are very similar to each other. Doesn't really matter.
Roger.
Eight resolve. Good. Inferno now. Now, who was shooting Inferno? Did the Raven just switch ammo or something? Interesting.
Good to go.
Yeah, Maki. this is the easiest thing to do here. And I think we can actually multi-target. Okay. No large laser. No small laser. Medium X-Pulse, small X-Pulse. Sorry, medium pulse, small X-Pulse. I think I'm gonna shoot the... medium pulse to B. And the small X-Pulse as well. I don't think that we need so much damage against the Locust, but actually we do. Okay, interesting. It was a good outcome nonetheless.
Critical hit, Commander.
Yeah, I was almost a kill. Almost isn't enough, I know, but I think splitting up here was netting us a very good outcome anyway. Just trying to mitigate the firepower on the battlefield here, and somebody else can take the Locust afterwards.
Yes, Commander.
For example, von Cobra. What about this? It's the same, so we might as well sprint. Yeah.
Going full throttle.
Going full throttle. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is what we do. This and then this, and we shoot the AC over to the Urban Mag.
Multiple enemies.
And that should be a kill on the Locust, finally. Very good. Oh, damn. 50-50, and it didn't connect.
No joy.
It's a stinger. Yeah, those light mechs are actually swarming me like crazy. That's a backstrike. Yeah, that's a backstrike and a half. I also will shoot the Locust. So, what do we need here? The PPC is in a good state. Shooting the Locust as well. Let's do it. That's a thing down. Sadly, our light PPC did not connect. But the AP Gauss were doing a wonderful job softening up the Locust already.
Ready for orders.
Which means... who are we going up against? Is it the Locust? Is it the Urban Mech? And if yes... Where from? It is the Urban Mech. We also have the Flamers on the Raven. We might be able to overheat the guy so that he's not able to fire this round. He is definitely critical. His engine is destroyed. Funnily enough, he's still on the legs. It's okay. And bam. Unidentified. Let's keep in mind that the commando is also very damaged. Ammo overheated? Oh. Ah. It's not an ER medium laser pirate, it's a medium laser pirate.
Yes, Commander.
The dream. The dream. Getting that melee mech.
Move order received.
I want it so bad. Alright, so no large laser. And then we are already fine.
Target confirmed.
This might be a kill, by the way. Okay, splashed it a bit too hard. But we have a head hit. And we have a side to also destruction. So I wonder what happens when we destroy the Urban Mech. Because at the moment we have 50% of the enemy reinforcements down. That was the Locust and that was the Pirate Commando, I believe. The ones that we destroyed already. But we still have three enemies here. Although it should have been only two. So, okay.
What's up, boss?
Again, enemies cheating a bit. That's fine. Okay for me. Aha, now we are getting into overheat territory.
I copy.
Not enough. But almost. The legs are very weak. He has to knock down. It's another pilot injury, but I think it's not enough here. So he's down to one health, right? Yeah, one out of three. Mm-hmm. Man, those swarms here. That's crazy. Commando coming closer again. Good. Good, good, good. Yeah.
confirmed.
Multi-target. We will go overheat, which I try to avoid, obviously. Tagging is okay, narking is okay. Yeah. I'm gonna overheat the guy. Also, pirate flamers, dealing more damage against already overheating targets. Did you see that? That was 50-something on the flamer. And the narc and the tag, just to maybe stress him a bit more. No, it doesn't help. So, that's a large laser. Ow! And that's a large laser to my missile arm, and I want to keep that missile arm. That's where my LRM 15 double plus is sitting in. Oh, we have to be a bit aware of where we position our catapult now.
Commander.
Speaking of...
Roll to that.
Can we do a triple kill? Ah, we're too hot for that. Double kill is definitely possible. No, it's not really... Maybe like that. Let's try. So there's one. There's two. Double kill. But not a triple. I love that. I love when a plan comes together, when the multi-target is actually working out and I have my estimations right. And it's just that. Yeah, we were lacking the firepower. If I had my other LRM or the PPC ready and I wouldn't go overheat, I might have destroyed his side jaws. And yet again, I don't know if this guy is running XL or not.
How's it going?
We will figure out now.
On the move.
Okay. Yeah, I think that's how we do it.
Copy that.
It doesn't state anything. I mean, yeah, his engine was destroyed, but it might have been... It might have been just the center torso that it was wrecked there. So. That was that. I didn't actually check whether or not we got the 75%. Yeah. Because of the double kill, we couldn't do that. I think the urban mech was one mech too much here. That's okay. We still have... Oh, no, wait. Destroyed supporting forces. 25% already. Ah. Okay, so we have the Raven, the Firestarter, and then this. Whatever this is.
Order.
Cobra, pushing up.
I'm already there.
Thank you. That's good. We can take a cooldown turn now,
yes,
and I think
Commander.
That's needed.
Hauling off.
Ah, there they are. Stinger. Yeah, Stinger, Raven... Firestarter. And then assassination target. So I believe pushing to the left side was the right choice here. It definitely definitely worked out for me.
Affirmative.
Mr. Raven. Okay. That's the Firestarter. Oh, and we are inspired. So do I wait for my Raven? Yes or no? Yeah, he's turn 20. We can do that. Crap. Can I sub? Yeah, I can be in their side. But, this is a bit risky what I'm doing there. Okay. We are being flanked by this guy now. Yeah. Firestarter, Stinger. It's definitely the Firestarter. He is the scarier target. Narked, tagged, and heat. Ah, he's running. Damn. And he's also running a large laser, and he is overheating my Uziel.
Watch my heat.
Damn, I wanted to follow up with that. Okay, Maki.
Standing by.
Going from here. Bip. I cannot shoot my machine gun array here. That thing is actually quite hot. I'm also choosing to not use Vigilance at the moment, although I know I could use it for damage reduction. The reason is that I want to keep being inspired. They gain a +2 bonus of accuracy and +1 initiative. That's really good.
Ready for orders.
Especially when hunting Lightmax, those little evasive bastards.
Fire full complement on the enemy.
Just like that. Oh, so close. So close. And he is knocked. So I cannot hit his back anymore. Because obviously the back is lying on the ground. Uh-huh. I'm gonna keep him for later. Raven is coming in as well. And now we get to see what he is running as his support system. Actually hit him. I think it was an arc. I think it was an arc. Good.
Awaiting orders.
Yeah, that's what we do. Oh yeah. Oh hell, that's what we do.
Tango down.
I love this. Oh, it's good. He is good, man. Holy hell. Now that was something, wasn't it?
Got it.
Let's finish the stinger. So, the Raven is gonna get backstabbed by my Raven, and then we will see what is coming up there as our main target. Is it an Atlas? I mean, it is very slow. It is extremely slow so far. I have the feeling that I want to keep some of my AP Gauss ammo for later. It might be needed. Yeah, flaming him does nothing here. I'd rather SRM him. For the chance of destroying his gyro or something. As I was saying, I want to keep them. I don't know what we are going up against there. Might be something nasty. And that's a dead Raven.
Enemy down.
Ah!
Waiting for orders.
Ah, that is pretty much, not quite, but right almost there. Flawless here. In before it's really an Atlas. I don't know. I don't think so. It has an initiative of 20. I have never seen an Atlas with initiative 20, I believe.
Yes, Commander. Roger that.
Okay, some cooldown turns here, especially on the Uziel. That was the Raven. There's another Raven. This is so weird. So we have an additional Urban Mech and we have an additional Raven on the field.
Reporting.
Might be the escorts for the assassination target. Yeah.
Inferno!
Standing by.
We will use Ulysses first. See if he can get the angle on the guy. Let's see if he can get some damage on the guy. And obviously, not the flamers. Hey, we have him tagged. That's good. Mm-hmm. Let's do it!
Copy that.
A 3% miss there. Hunchback! Okay, now we know what it is. 50 ton mech, I would take it. If I can get my hands on the Hunchback. Yep. This guy is running Inferno stuff.
Losing lots of armor.
We had lots of armor? That was 1 point. Come on, Starbird, that was 1 point. Don't be such a sissy.
Awaiting orders.
Nah, everything is blocked. I can't go anywhere. I want to use Ulysses first anyway. And let the Hunchback come a bit closer.
Yeah, let's just see what happens.
Where to go? I think like that?
On my way.
Yeah, double perfect. Tap. Yeah, we even got the backstrike. Vigilant. Now we use Vigilant. We have the resolve to utilize that. We are still inspired and I don't want to get hit by those guys. Let me see what he's running. It's a Gridiron, it's another Gauss. Gauss Hunchback.
Location confirmed.
Get rid of the Raven first.
Acknowledge.
Almost.
That hit something good.
Yeah, we have to knock down. This might enable us to not go for the Raven any further in this round. And I think this is actually what we do. We deal with the Hunchback now from this point on. Starboard. First. No! Unfortunate.
Wilco.
Unfortunate. We can only shoot indirectly. I will not shoot. I won't do it. We need to cool down. Oh no, and now we blocked each other. Oh, worst case scenario. Ack. Okay.
Target damage. Concentrate your fire and bring it down.
Yeah, yeah, we try. I should have initiative over him though. What the hell? Sorry for that, guys. That was my thing here. Yeah, this is what we do. We go in his back. Hopefully we get to
Roger that.
Crit his Gauss rifle. I see a bunch of threes. And that's a dead Hunchback.
I'm taking heat
damage. What happens now? It still says go to the evac.
Good. Good to go.
So we actually have to destroy the Raven. Let's go for it. Not like that though.
Locked on target.
Maybe he's doing me the favor and just punch out? Or we just alpha strike him to death.
10-4.
7-7-7-5-5-5-5-5 and then more and more and more! I like this build, guys. I really do. All targets eliminated. Sit tight and I can collect you from where you are right now.
Mission successful.
Pretty good. I think we completely wrecked the Hunchback, though. This Gauss was completely violently erupting in the inner parts of the mech and then blowing outside and scrap metal and shrapnel and explosions everywhere. I think this mech is barely salvageable. But if... Then we're gonna take a look at that. The Gridiron has an interesting quirk. I think it is a Gauss range quirk, which means you can do ridiculous long-range shots with that. Given the fact that you have the sensors, then. Catapult was actually MVP here. It's good. Yeah, and we don't have a Gridiron part yet. Ooh. Ooh, 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 ooh. I read something. I think what happens now is... correct me if I'm wrong, guys. Maybe I'm wrong in this regard. The mechs don't have the quirks anymore, but they have those built-in fixed parts that you can replace if you just kind of quote-unquote overwrite them. You place another item onto them, and those parts have that special quirk. As in the ammo in our Hydra catapult, as it has it in the legs, and it's fixed ammo that applies to the missiles. To the missile launchers that we have in there. And I think the Gridiron here has that special Gauss rifle and not that regular quote-unquote Gauss quirk anymore. Interesting thing. Very interesting. That was a Munin. Oh, cool. We could take the Raven to finish it. Would be another Raven. Oh, how do we go about this? Can we even build them together from regular Hunchback parts now? Or is it still a special mech that you have to have the full parts of? I don't know. Oh, there's a Bombast Laser. It's very intriguing to get... yeah, I need to get that. That's a Bombast Laser, guys. That's 90 damage pinpoint. Or only 38 heat. I'll take that. Yep. So this Pirate Laser is just damage variation. Plus one accuracy. It's okay. There's another pulse laser. I like that. Come sweet. It is good, but it's not a priority. Re-resolve though. It's good. That's actually really good. Patchwork. Basically toning up a mech. What is that? AX. The warhead replaces the normal explosive charge of the standard short-range missiles with a small tank of a gelled acid. Weakening a target's resistance. On a critical hit, any remaining ammunition stored inside, blah blah blah, will explode. Target takes 30% more damage for 2 turns. Minus 1 accuracy, minus 3 damage. That is crazy. 30% more damage. Wow. I like that idea. I really do. Imagine that on a Raven, right? Not going for regular damage, but just priming the enemies. It's like, you have a tech, have a narc, and have acid. And then everybody's like, oh, thanks for the information. Thank you for the sensors. Thank you for the target information. Thank you for the accuracy bonus. And thank you for the damage bonus. Let's go. 30% is ridiculous. Yeah, let's go. Sadly, we cannot really go further into the mech building part here. But I want the medium pulse. I want the bombast. And everything else is rather irrelevant. This is good. This is really good. Comes sweet. But it's not better than this year. I need the pulse. I need the accuracy. Okay. We get the Raven parts. Cool. We have a Firestarter part. Medium laser. Tagger. Oh, Tagger. Interesting. Acquisition gear grants 5 to sensor checks on hit that decays for minus 1 each hex the target has moved. Oh, it acts as a target acquisition gear. Wait. No, okay, so if you paint a target with that, you get that. Also ignores evasion, gets plus 1 accuracy, damage falloff. I mean, it's 8 damage. It's just a laser combined with attack. It's just a good thing. I'll take that. 2 improved accuracy against its target. Yeah, our Raven is gonna be our toolkit. Okay, guys. We're gonna rebuild the Raven so that we can straighten its role a bit more. This is not about damage anymore. This is just about priming the target. And then a single SRM-6 filled with those AX SRM bins is just good enough because you just need to hit one. You have 6 chances to apply the 30% damage buff. And that's good. That's really good. I like that idea. That's cool. I want to play that. Oh, I'm hyped. I'm super hyped, guys. And then we follow up with, I don't know, an AC-10. What is that? 30% more? That is around about 20 damage. Is that it? Am I right? I don't know. Is that 20%, 20 damage increase? Round about 18, actually. 18? I'm, again, not good at math in my head. But that's a lot. You can do reliable headshots with that. Come on, Raven. Give me my mech. Game. Please. Yeah, at the moment, Yang is just assembling the stuff together in the mech bay so that I can see what this Raven brings to the table. There we go. Aha! Based on the 3L, it removed the SRM-6 launcher, the medium lasers, and the electronic warfare systems and tech laser in order to turn the Raven into a long-range fire support unit. I want to see what we can do with that thing before we do anything else. Let's take a look. Mm-hmm. Raven 3M. It's running Pharaoh. Okay. So it has the NARC still. It has 2 small lasers, a small pulse. Didn't they say long range? There's the comms suite. It had an XL engine, not anymore. There's a fusion core destroyed. It has the faster than light ammo, the follow the leader missile. And then LRM-15, ah, that's why. Plus even. I would have taken that. Interesting. FDL on an LRM-15 with high accuracy. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I can see that thing working. It's a all or nothing thing then. Alright, but I will scrap this thing. I don't need another Raven. Do I? No, we have the support systems here. This is just enough. I want the Tagger, I want the ammo, and then we just cut the flamers. Anyhow, guys, that is your episode for Rogue Take for today. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, then don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you want more of this. If you want to support me, go down below to the description. There is the link to my Patreon page, and I hope to see you guys next time. Goodbye.